Okay. Great. So, check, check. Thank you. Thank you for coming out. My name is Rafael Karlen, and it's my pleasure to be on stage with these wonderful, wonderful musicians. It's been a while getting this happening. It was recorded in 2018, and it was meant to be toured in 2020, and now we're here. And I'm really excited. The first single came out yesterday, and building into an album launch. If you're really interested, I will have a mailing list. Yes, it's in the car. I can definitely bring the mailing list and put it there. So please sign up and do all that stuff. I'd like to introduce Jo Lawry, a wonderful singer who's singing so beautifully, and it's a real pleasure. Matt McMahon on piano. Wonderful. Brett Hirst. Sorry, yeah. Please thank Jo and Matt. It's been so long between gigs. My gig banter is subpar, but that's okay. By the end of the night, it'll be better. And we have Brett Hirst on bass. And James Waples on drums. So I should just say, first of all, thank you to Lynette Owen, who instigated this many years ago when she commissioned a few of us to compose music for the opening of the Brisbane International Jazz Festival, and it's taken this long to get some of those pieces recorded. Everything with lyrics, is the difference. Everything with lyrics was for that 2014 Jazz Festival, and I haven't had much mileage with them, so that's why I'm really excited to share them. The first tune is called Rich Hours, and it is wordless. Thank you. this is going to be really fun. So this is, I'm really excited. This is also the first time we've all played together on stage at the same time. And normally it's a disclaimer, but I'm really excited, so I want to share that with you, because it's very, very special. So this next one is called A Generation of Sunrises, or Blueprint of Possibility. It got retitled for the album. And has lyrics by a friend, Ewan Gray. And it came from a suite called Arrivals and Prospects. I got there. And it was about looking forward and looking backwards and the different ways we can do that. So two ways of looking forward. One is with excitement and anticipation about a future destination. That's the positive spin. Or the negative one is when you look forward and you look to the future with less positive emotions and you're a little anxious. This is looking forward with nice positive emotions, and it's uplifting, followed by something else which I'll introduce shortly. So this is A Blueprint of Possibilities.
La 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 delivery, a stock lack of memory, an otherworldly blueprint of possibilities. A string is pulling me toward and beyond you, leading us to the inspired distance. Today is my favorite day, held aloft with an air of presidential prose. A generation of sunrises, an eternity of today's has only just begun.
So now comes the probably the darkest track of the set. This one's called Evening Corridors, and it's titled for when you kind of end up getting a little bit stuck in some thoughts. So looking backwards and not really in a useful way. And yeah, some lovely colors and textural landscapes. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
is in circles around my stagnant room. A laced footpath of everything.
Would you like to talk about the next one?
Sure. Well, Rafael's been kind enough to offer me to do it, to add a set, tune or two of my own in the set. I would like to really claim the music for this, but I can't. The music actually was written by my husband, alto player Will Vinson. There's one Will Vinson, or two Will Vinson fans in the room. With lyrics by me, this was written in Toscana, looking over fields of olive trees inspired by that site. So this is called Olive Tree.
You said, let's plant an olive tree. I said, I heard they take forever to grow. And do we have the weather? You said, well, what if we two got to lose? I said, don't we need more sunlight? You said, here's a patch that's just right. Come, love, it will be fun, love. And so we got on our knees and prayed for sun and rain and bees, and that somehow we two would know the ways to get a tree to grow.
Solo from our wonderful bass player yet. So this is a little feature for Brett Hirst. It's called Before the Day. Thank you. Okay, so far, timing's pretty good. The first set is almost over, but we have at least as much left. This is the title track. It's called Equally True, and it was titled for a few things. One is because it's in 6 and 3 at the same time, cheeky music nerd, and 4 and 2 as well. But also because kind of different truths to the same thing, and they're both true, and that gets complicated. So this is equally true.
La 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 la
thank you so much for coming out and supporting live music instead of fireworks. It is tonight, right? Or is it tomorrow night? Well, thank you anyway. I'll take it. I thought it was tonight. I heard the Jets, so I was like, it's got to be tonight. All right. Well, thank you. Please put your hands together for this wonderful band. It's such a pleasure to be on stage with these incredible musicians. We'll take a short break and we'll see you shortly. Thank you. Right. Thank you so much for coming or not leaving. And it's one of the worst feelings when you start a gig and halfway through everyone leaves. I've heard. So this next tune is the single, which sounds so funny to say, but it's a thing now where jazz musicians can release singles. And so it's available online, and anyone who is interested in purchasing, actually, yeah, probably, join the mailing list, please, because I will send updates, not often, because I'm not very organized, but when they do happen, then they give you opportunities to hear music. And, yeah, this is the track, first single called Again, As Always, and this was written originally for piano trio, as in classical piano trio, with Matt, a classical cellist, and a classical violinist. And I thought that was cool, but I'd like to open it up more, and it was revisited for this ensemble, and I like this one much more. Thank you. This next one is called 7 Seconds After Sleep. Sometimes tunes are titled, because you're like, this is definitely the feeling of it, and this is one of those. It wasn't like a, oh, this is the title, I need to write a piece for it. It was definitely the other way around. And yeah, it's going to have a lovely piano solo first up. As in first soloist. Please be lenient. This is my third gig. I was thinking about this in the conversation. This is my third gig since pre-COVID. It's so weird. It's so nice being in front of people and making music and sharing again. But all these things like introductions and banter. So we can have a debrief later, and you can provide me some notes and some scorecards. Thank you.
You're doing well.
Thank you.
Yeah, so you're the first time. I'm going to have to say that.
So this next one is called Foucault's Pendulum. And you know, when I first found out what that was, I was kind of impressed. I didn't know. Maybe everyone else knew except me. But it was really cool. And I found out there's, you can set up a big pendulum and it moves, but it looks like it's the Earth's rotation that makes it look like it's moving, not the pendulum. Should look it up. It's much better than my description. Foucault's Pendulum.
Thank you.
Jo Lawry.
Shall I introduce the next one?
Can you please? So this is actually really, this is a beautiful, beautiful song that I have heard quite a few times and even played once, and I loved it. And I totally forgot it existed. And then I asked Jo if she had any other suggestions of tunes, and she brought this in, and I got really excited. And I got even more confused when I realized how it was pronounced. So this is a tune that Jo is going to introduce.
This is a tune by the fantastic Brazilian composer, guitarist, pianist, Egberto Gismonchi. And it's a tune of his called Palhaço, meaning, well, my pronunciation is not good, but it's probably, I think it's closer than the other. It's Palhaço, which is clown in Portuguese. Playing Palhaço again, don't you know? It looks like you're really past caring, with that painted on smile that you're wearing. Why can't I quite believe all of this pantomime show? You're laughing now. A secret that glimmers behind them. It's only a dream of your own creation. And darling, one moment you'll wake up, take leave of your costume and makeup. You'll take one last bow, walk the ring one last time.
Beautiful tune. If you are, I do recommend a look at that one too. Spelt, I don't know. What's the, no, that's wrong one completely. What's the C with the thing on the bottom?
I don't know, the C with the little hook underneath it. P-A-L-H-A-C, yeah. Whatever that is. Oh,
it reads Palhaker, but that's definitely not what it is. But it's beautiful. The recordings of Charlie Hayden doing it, and it's incredible. This is one of the other four tunes that have lyrics in the set. This is called My Own Quiet Library, and this was written to express the feelings of looking backwards, but with a nice warm nostalgia, not the kind of darker movement we had before. So this is the uplifting one of reminiscing. And it's going to feature Brett throughout.
Sepia.
So, almost on time. This is the final. Sorry, I had some charts at the back. I was like, whoa, that's a lot. No, this is the last one. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you to JMI and Nick and the whole team who, please give a round of applause to JMI and Nick for hosting that music. It's such a great place to play, and it's so lovely to share, make music in this room with all of you. Thanks again for coming. I would like to introduce the band again. We have James Waples on the drums. Brett Hirst on the bass. Matt McMahon on the piano. Jo Lawry on the microphone. And it's my pleasure being responsible. So I thought for this, because I thought about how to build this gig, and it was they have like Art Pepper plus 11. You have albums like that with like one person and the rest, but kind of felt like everyone else had more profile than me. So it was kind of like, how do you build that gig? So it's all our names, and it's so fun for me to bring this music to life with these incredible musicians. This last tune is called The Promise of Postcards, and it's about looking forward. That's right, looking forward with a little bit more anxiety. It's not the most uplifting one, but it's a nice one to finish on because musically it makes sense and has a bit of a vibe. So this is called The Promise of Postcards, and it has lyrics by Ewan Gray, and was commissioned for the Brisbane International Jazz Festival a few years ago, and was the impetus for this whole project. So thank you all for coming.
That's Rafael Karlen, everybody. Da 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 da
displacing the horizon. I find myself alone and derived, far from the sea and closer to home. My companions reduced to dissipating echoes.
Rafael Karlen, everybody.